Well, welcome into Getting Help from Uncle Sam, or it could be our guest, because we have with us Brian Moore, who is an attorney at law. And Brian has helped quite a few of my friends that have had problems because they've become a little bit older. They maybe are a widow or a widower or become divorced. And now two of them are coming together and things aren't working out too well. So Brian, basically what we're talking about is when people get to be our age, not your age, you're younger than I am, but then when they get to be 65, 70 years old and they've got kids and they've got a family and they are either widowed or divorced, and then all of a sudden they find another person, what do they really need to do to kind of protect themselves?
Well, one of the first things they can do is come in, and quite frankly, I would suggest both parties come in and discuss a prenuptial agreement. Okay. Now, I know most folks think when they think about prenuptial agreement, they think about Hollywood and yes. millionaires yes. and, you know. But the reality is, you know, generally speaking, when people come into a second marriage, they bring assets to that marriage, mm-hmm. you know, whether it's property, whether it's financial means, whatever the case may be. And so basically all a prenuptial agreement says is, whatever you bring into the marriage is yours. Whatever I bring into the marriage is mine.
Okay.
And then whatever we accrue during our marriage is ours. So okay. that God forbid something, the marriage doesn't work out, we mm-hmm. divorce, whatever the case may be. Whatever you brought in, you take with you. I take with me whatever I brought in. Mm-hmm. And then we divide whatever we have accrued together.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it doesn't mean a prenup that you're going in assuming the marriage is going to fail.
Right.
All it means is it's, you know, like I gave you the example, you know, you buy insurance on your house.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you assume you're never going to need that insurance. You assume the house is not going to burn down or the house is not going to get blown away. But in the event it does, you have mm-hmm. this insurance. A prenup agreement is really no different. It's just insurance, if you will. You hope you never need it. But if you do, it's there to protect what you have coming in into the marriage. Mm-hmm.
So when this is happening and the two come together and they do a prenup, then do you still need a will for the two of them?
Absolutely.
Yeah, even more so than I think at that point.
Yeah, absolutely, right? Because you're still going to, you know, you may go out and buy a house together.
Mm-hmm.
Or you may both sell the houses you had
and then go
and
to a
contribute
third,
that, right? You know, mm-hmm. to each buying a house. Well, you need that will to distinguish, okay, we're going to, if something happens, we're going to divide the interest in this house.
Mm-hmm.
And anything you accrue, I mean, you just don't need to leave it, again, to the state of Alabama to determine who obtains those assets that you've accrued together as a couple mm-hmm. on your second marriage.
And a lot of times what will happen is, I know a case where a woman became a widow and her husband had quite a nice retirement, so she didn't want to, she would lose that if she remarried.
Mm-hmm.
And so they didn't marry by going to the courthouse and get a marriage license, but they went into a church and got married.
Mm-hmm.
That gets a little sticky too, doesn't it?
Well, it does. You know, at one time, Alabama recognized what is called or referred to as common law marriages.
Common law, right.
In 2016, the Alabama legislature, in essence, did away with common law marriage effective January 1st, 2017, and said that Alabama is no longer going to recognize for legal purposes a common law marriage. A common law marriage was basically you're old enough to get married,
mm-hmm.
you have the legal ability to get married, and you hold yourself out. In essence, or you present yourself as a married couple.
Right.
And so that created problems, trying to determine, well, are you married or are you not married?
And sometimes they even had kids together.
And had
Absolutely.
Kids together,
yeah.
That's right. And now,
yes.
if you had a common law marriage prior to that law going into effect, they grandfathered that in, but you know, each one is determined, quite frankly, just by the facts of the relationship,
mm-hmm.
you know, whether it truly is a common law marriage or not. If it is, you know, again, you know, whether it is or whether it isn't, you still need a will to determine
yes.
how you're going to divide your assets, mm-hmm. particularly then when you have children, which is a whole nother, mm-hmm. you know, issue.
Okay, for our viewers, if they want information or want to be able to visit with you, we're putting up your name and all the contact
okay.
information. And this has been very good information because a lot of people ask questions, but I think the biggest thing we take away from this thing is make sure you know what your will is, you know.
Absolutely.
Because that's what the term will means. What do I want, you know?
Put your will in the will so the world knows what you want.
Absolutely. Great way to put it. Okay, and thank you for being with us. And
thank
just
you.
Remember this, when you're getting into these times, go to a professional. Don't go online and think, well, I can take care of this by myself, because there's a lot of added areas that, especially if you're living in the state of Alabama, that you need to look at. And we'll be right back right after this.